as a supporter in an NBC town hall of the president. Was it nodding in agreement?
Absolutely not in an agreement, because I was following exactly what he was saying, and that's my sentiment as well. Not emotionally, but from the logical point of view. So it's just natural to follow the conversation, and then when you feel like what the person is saying is correct, I nod it in approval.
How did you feel about the treatment of the president by Savannah Guthrie?
It's like every other presentation that the president have had. It's like the president is fighting with one hand tied behind his back, in which the judge and the prosecutor are both against the attorney practically. So there is no way that anybody can have a decent conversation when from the get-go it's just attacks. And it's not only a town hall, it's been the norm throughout the whole candidacy and presidency of the President Trump and their supporters, aka myself. I am not being a victim of attacks just because I just was sitting behind the president, happened to be sitting behind the president. I've been the victim of attacks just because I express my views, and I'm a person who think on her own, and I'm a grown woman, a businesswoman, and I believe that that's the right that I do have to come to this country and think for myself.
When I watched, you know, the first 20 minutes of this, Leo, and then here we go again. Are you going to condemn white nationalism? Okay. He's done it how many times? We played it earlier in the show. And then we get to QAnon, Leo, and I'm like, okay, really? This is what you want to know? Joe Biden, he's never been asked about his kind words about the former Klansman Robert Byrd, the guy that filibustered the Civil Rights Act, or the fact that he worked with him to stop integration of schools, didn't want his kids going to schools that are racial jungles. Not one time, Leo, not one time has he ever been asked.
And you know, Sean, I'll tell you right now, last night, those two town halls was a perfect example. The Republicans are always fighting uphill because the media is so far left and so far in the pocket of the Democratic Party. Savannah Guthrie was trying to maintain her invitation to Democratic cocktail parties, and that's why she went off. The president has answered the race question 20, 30 times. It's all on tape. But she still goes on and answers that question. And I'll tell you, the reason why I'm here, the reason why I'm supporting Donald Trump, the reason why I won't even be on your program next week, I'm campaigning across the country for the president.
You're going to be on the program. We'll find a way. You look better in the hat, to be honest. Where's the hat tonight?
I'm telling you right now, I'm so excited. I'm campaigning all next week for the president. And Joe Biden was asked that question about you ain't black. He didn't answer it. He did not answer that question. You know
how about integration? How about his praise of Klansmen? Can you imagine if Donald Trump praised the Klansmen?
Donald Trump, Sean, has declared the Klan a domestic terrorist group. But what I'm saying is the Democrats will not confront Joe Biden. It's a double standard. And by the way, you cannot communicate with Republicans or you're a sellout. I am proud to be working for Donald Trump. I'm on the campaign all week next week.
Myra, did you get to meet the president?
I do. I did get to meet the president. He was right directly talking to me, saying, you know, he was mentioning Sammy Sosa, who is Dominican as well. And I also talk a little bit. Yeah, because what people don't understand is that Democratic Party, I was a former Democrat. The Democratic Party left me. When we have a party who is willing, to kill a baby, I cannot be alone with that. That's the money.
There's a lot of people like her, Sean. There's a lot of blacks are going to the president. He's going to get record numbers.
All right. We'll know in 18 days. All right.